Wow, this is another day that the Lord has made, and we are going to rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Wow, and I just want to share with you some of the testimonies that we normally experience during our ministration. There are powerful testimonies that are out there. And today I want to share with you one of these profound testimonies. I was actually at home, just sitting at home, and suddenly I saw myself in Dubai. And then when I got to Dubai, I had a meeting with these guys. And as I was having a meeting with these guys, and we discussed after the meeting, I went out to town, walking around, and I was there with my flesh and blood. And as I was walking around, and I was aware that I was there, and then I was away, but I even asked myself, but how did I come here? Because I never saw myself going through to the airport or anything like that. And I'm based in South Africa, Pretoria. I said, I'm based in South Africa now, I'm in Dubai, but how did I get to Dubai? Then I was actually even worried, how am I going to get back home? But later on, suddenly I was at home, I was back at home. I said, wow, what really happened here? I thought I was dreaming. But it was not a dream. You know, a dream, you will know that I was sleeping in night, right? But it's something that you saw yourself there. And fortunate enough, I had a diary with me when I was there. When I looked at my diary, I saw the telephone numbers of the people in Dubai. And I began to phone them. I said, guys, was I there? And they said, yes, you were here. What's wrong? I said, no, man, there's something that I'm busy checking. I went to look at my passport. When I look at my passport, I can see that it was not stamped out in Dubai, because when I was going to the United States, I did not get out. I passed through Dubai, but I didn't get out of the airport in Dubai. I just interconnected another flight from Dubai. But my passport doesn't say Dubai at all. Then I got worried. I got worried and I began to speak to people. I said, you know what, this is what I've experienced. And people said, hey, now we're going to take you to a mental hospital. You cannot begin to speak things like this. You're getting mad. And it worried me so much that I ended up even keeping quiet. Because another experience, it was not an out-of-body experience. It was like a teletransportation experience, whereby my whole body with me, myself, and I, the way I am, like how Stephen was with that Ethiopian eunuch, after he prayed for him, after he read for him the Bible says, then he disappeared and he went to the nearest town. That is what exactly happened, same as how Jesus even appeared when he was with his disciples. And we've got the Lord. After I read the Bible enough, after I've experienced that, wow, this really happened in the Bible, then I began to say, wow, then that fear, it left me. So that was one of the experiences where I had like an out-of-body experience. Then I was busy watching television. As I was watching television, I had this other person, he began to speak as well. He said, I went from this place to this place. Then I said to myself, wow, so this thing is real. This thing is happening. So I began to even begin to experience that more, because I began to accept and believe in my spirit to say, this thing is really happening. I'm not crazy. And then it happened all the time. And I said to myself, wow, wow, wow. But and also, it came to an extent whereby I wanted to actually control it, but unfortunately, I couldn't control it. Where you want to go to a specific place and come back, but it only happened by itself. And I remember as well, I went to India as well. When I got there, I began to evangelize to people. As I was busy evangelizing to people, I led them to Christ. And there were other people as well that are busy. As I was busy evangelizing to another Arab nation, they did not want to give themselves to Christ and all that. They were like Islamic and all that. I was kind of like disappointed as I was busy evangelizing, hoping that I'm going to lead them to Christ. And I came back again. So this teletransportation that I've experienced is one of the profound experiences that happened in my life, where I even went to also visit my sister. She stays about an hour drive from where I'm sitting, where I live. And I was at home, and suddenly I was at her place. And I visited her, and after visiting her, I came back again home. And after that, I called her. I said, "My sister, was I there at your place?" She said, "Yes, you were here." And I didn't know how did I get there. But anyway, it happened just like this. And that is one of the testimonies that all the experiences that one is experiencing. So if you are experiencing such kind of experiences, know that you're not crazy, you're not dreaming, they are ready. Amen. So yes, be blessed with those experiences. May God bless you. And I'm going to also share with you some of the other testimonies later. Have a blessed day, and God bless you all. Bye for now.